My name is Hana Kadanka. I came to Canada from Czech Republic, that was Czechoslovakia in those days. I was born with congenital heart disease and I had to have a surgery to have it corrected. I grew up during the Second World War in a city called Ostrava, in a very loving family, but I missed one thing. There were no friends of my age in our area, so my best friends were my pets. One of them was my goat Pucina. Pucina went everywhere with me, even into the cellar during the air raids and bombing of our city. After the war, the goat had to be put down because the food was very scarce, but I still remember many funny moments with her and I cherish all the photographs. My dad taught me to love nature and from him I really got a love of traveling through the hills, putting up with unpleasant situations, walking through the rain, but still having a lot of fun. In 1948, my country changed from one of the most advanced democratic country in Europe into a country under the rule of communism. Instinctively, I knew that whatever was political discussion in our house, I cannot speak of it outside because there was no freedom of speech, no freedom of press, and one had to be very careful. People were afraid. My biggest sorrow was that I would never be able to travel and see all places in the world. I had this beautiful book of geography with pictures of all kinds of places. I remember one in particular, photo of Florida, with blue sea and the palms. I was looking at it and I felt such an anger and disappointment that I will never be able to see it. In spite of that, I had a very happy childhood. Later on, I was thinking what I wanted to study. First, it was humanities because of my interest in literature and languages. Eventually, medicine won, and I think it was because of my hospital experience. When I was in university, I met my future husband, Zdeněk Kadanka. We both graduated the same year, and then we moved into one of the most beautiful places in Czech Republic called Luhačovice. There we lived very happy life with our two daughters. Then came year of 1969 and that was so-called Prague Spring. Alexander Dubček became a leader of Communist Party and many reforms brought more freedom. People stopped being afraid to voice their opinion. All of us were hoping that Czechoslovakia will be turning at least a little bit toward the previous democracy. But I remember how in the night in August 21st, when the massive sound of flying airplanes woke me up. In the morning, we heard on the radio that Soviet tanks and army has invaded our republic and that there is fighting in the streets of Prague. Reforms were cancelled, freedoms of speech disappeared, people were punished. Mr. Dubček was called to Moscow and then demoted from his position. That was the end of Prague Spring and what was achieved was completely gone. That was the time when my husband and I started to think about leaving our country, the country we loved and never thought of leaving before. But we knew that the situation is going to be worse, so we decided that we will leave. We had a chance to go for holidays to Yugoslavia, and by enormous luck, we got a visa that allowed us to travel through Austria. So we stepped out of train in Vienna with our two daughters, with two suitcases and no money. We decided to start new life. It was a bit scary, but we were young, healthy, and we were full of optimism. We believed that we would be able to build our life all over again somewhere else. And that's what we have done.